What's going on, everyone? This is another Chris Course with your host Chris, and in this video we are going to cover the package manager developed and used by Facebook in production Yarn. In collaboration with Google, Exponent, and Tilda, Facebook has created a package manager that provides a number of benefits over its NPM counterpart, including the auto-generation of log files, quicker package downloads, the ability to download packages offline, and emojis. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get up and running with Yarn while helping you understand why you'd want to use it over existing package managers such as NPM. So let's begin. Alright, to install Yarn, the first thing we're going to do is open up our terminal. And from here, installation is simple. We are going to run npm install yarn --global, which will install our package globally so we can run Yarn from any directory we'd like. Cool, so simple enough, right? We have Yarn downloaded, and we can use it to download any package from registries such as npm and bower. Let's see it in action so we can better understand some of the benefits it provides. Create and cd into a project directory. Now, normally, to install a package, we would use something like npm install and then the package name. But with Yarn, the syntax is a little different. To install a package with Yarn, we are going to type yarn, add, and then the name of the package we'd like to install. I'm going to use Express for mine. Now before we run this, I'm going to open up a second terminal window, create and cd into a new project directory, and set up the npm equivalent of our yarn script so we can compare the two side by side. And before I actually run this, I'm going to add a time command to the beginning of each of these so we can see how long each process takes to actually finish. So if we run this on our left npm terminal, you'll see that npm installed our package and left us a message in regards to how long it took to do so. And if we run our right yarn terminal, you'll see that Yarn installed our package a bit quicker than npm did. Now, when Yarn installs a package, it stores all of its dependencies in what's known as a global cache. Essentially, this is a directory on our computer that stores any packages we've downloaded so that we don't have to travel across the internet when we want to download them again. And the cool thing is, if I already have a log file in place, which we'll go over later, and I've already downloaded the packages listed within this file at least once, our download times are going to be super quick. Not to mention, we'll be able to download these packages offline. Let me show you. If I remove our node modules folder, disconnect from the internet, and run yarn add express again, just like that, Yarn has cut a significant amount of time off of our install. So as you can see, there are some serious speed benefits here, which will save you minutes, if not hours and days worth of time in the long run. Now, if we list out our files, you'll see that Yarn has generated what's known as a lock file. Now, what is this and why do we need it? A lock file is a list that contains all of the dependencies required for your project to function. This file basically locks down your dependency versions so that whenever someone else runs yarn install, they'll receive all of the exact dependencies listed out here, ensuring that your team has the exact same packages as you do while preventing bugs that can appear due to the introduction of new untested packages. So if we head on over to our npm terminal, you'll notice that we don't have a lock file. All we have is a package.json file and our node modules. Now, this package.json file includes details in regards to what dependencies our project requires, but it's not comprehensive. We have no list of the exact dependencies that something like Express depends upon in order to function. Yarn may list all of these dependencies for us automatically, but to do so with npm, we need to run an npm shrinkwrap command. With this in place, any developer can run npm install, and they'll prompt npm to automatically download the exact packages listed within this shrinkwrap file. And since we're downloading exact packages, we don't have to worry about bugs due to the introduction of new or updated packages. So npm provides lock file functionality, but since humans are forgetful and may forget to run the npm shrinkwrap command, not to mention that this is something that can and should be automated, it results in npm being a second best alternative to something like Yarn. So a few more cool things about Yarn. If you look over at our Yarn terminal, you'll notice that I never typed --save when we installed our Express package. And that's because Yarn adds any installed packages to our package.json file automatically. Same thing goes for uninstalling packages. If we uninstall a package with npm, you'll notice that our package.json file didn't get updated automatically. If we wanted to update our package.json file, we'd have to run npm uninstall express --save. And you'll notice that we error out. And that's because we just uninstalled Express. npm is looking for a package to uninstall, but it can't find one at the moment. So we have to reinstall Express as a result. Then with Express reinstalled, we can run npm uninstall express --save in order for all of this to work as expected. And if we view our package.json file now, you'll see that Express has indeed been removed. With Yarn, updating our package.json file when removing a package is easy. Simply type yarn, remove, and then the package you'd like to uninstall. And you'll see if we visit our yarn package.json file, it's been completely updated automatically for us. Now let's say we want to save something as a dev dependency. Rather than use npm install and then the package name --save dev, we'd use yarn add, and then the package name --dev. So you see, Yarn provides not only speed and consistency, but also provides for a succinct interface by replacing long command line statements with short ones, if not automating the process altogether. If you ever need to know why a particular package or dependency was installed, or why it exists on your project, simply type yarn, y, and then the package name, and Yarn will detail out the exact reasoning as to why that package was installed and what packages depend upon it. So really, really cool features here from Yarn, something you may not expect out of a package manager. So that's all for this one, folks. I hope you enjoyed and got some useful information out of this. If you found this video useful or helpful in any sort of way and would like to see more development tutorials in the future, then subscribe and keep an eye out for new videos throughout the week. I try to release at least one every 2 to 4 days. Otherwise, I hope you all have a fantastic day, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next video. Later!